Привет, and welcome to lesson 18 of the Russian language course with Dmitry Slomov. We have been talking about planning our activities for today or tomorrow, and today we shall talk about our plans for the whole week. So, today we shall talk about the days of a week. In Russia, a week starts with Monday and ends with Sunday. So, if you see a Russian calendar, please keep this in mind. So, let's say Lisa is looking at the calendar and she is planning her week. Let's say today the week has successfully started in Russia. So, it is Monday. In Russian, понедельник. Понедельник. Like, on Monday, a pony makes a deal with Nick. Pony, deal, Nick. Понедельник. Lisa says to herself, so, today it is Monday. So, when it is used as a silence filler, in Russian, так, так. You may just say, так, 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 так. Lisa says, так, сегодня понедельник. And she continues, today in the evening I shall go to Chris. Remember, the word Chris changes when someone goes to Chris. So it is к Крису. Сегодня вечером я пойду к Крису. She is just planning. She has not yet made such a strong decision to say, tonight I am going to Chris. Сегодня вечером я иду к Крису. But of course she could. So, we may say that on Monday in the evening, Lisa will go to Chris. On Monday, in Russian, в понедельник. В понедельник. Like in Monday. В понедельник. So we may say, в понедельник вечером Лиса пойдет к Крису. В понедельник вечером Лиса пойдет к Крису. Very good. Tuesday in Russian, вторник. Вторник. It is considered the second day of the week. So remember we said half past one, half of the second hour. Пол второго. This is somewhat similar to the second day of the week. Вторник. On Tuesday, во вторник. The word в becomes в, just to make it easier to pronounce. So, Lisa is saying to herself, remember, it is Monday today, and tomorrow it is Tuesday. Завтра вторник. Во вторник утром я иду на работу. She surely goes to work. It is not something optional. So she says, я иду. Во вторник утром я иду на работу. Actually, a Russian working week starts with Monday. But let's say Lisa did not have to go to work on Monday. And on Tuesday evening, she has been invited to go to a restaurant with her Russian colleagues. A guy whose name is Ivan and a girl whose name is Vika. So, it is quite sure that she goes. Restaurant, in Russian, ресторан. With с. With Ivan, the word Ivan changes because someone goes with him. So, with Ivan, с Иваном. С Иваном. The word Ivan gets the ending ом. С Иваном. Now, with Вика, the word Вика ends with а. So it gets another ending and becomes с Викой. С Викой. It gets the ending ой. С Викой. With Иван с Иваном. With Вика с Викой. Let's hear some more names and how they change when someone goes with these people. Иван с Иваном. Борис с Борисом. Крис с Крисом. Джефф с Джеффом. Вика с Викой. Анна с Анной. Рита с Ритой. Лиса с Лисой. So, Lisa says, во вторник вечером я иду с Иваном и с Викой в ресторан. Now, very often, when Russians mean I shall go with someone to some place, or I am going with someone to some place, they usually say, like, we go with someone to some place. Lisa could better say, мы идем с Иваном и с Викой в ресторан. This sounds somewhat better in Russian. Мы идем с Иваном в ресторан. Or, мы идем с Викой в ресторан. Like, I am going with Vika. Or, во вторник вечером мы идем с Иваном и с Викой в ресторан. Great. Now, let's look at some more names. Let's take those that end with A. But before A, there is a so-called soft sound, like L and not L, or Ny and not N. Or it may be also Y and Sh sounds. In this case, the ending is slightly different. So, ladies first. Юля с Юлей. Наташа с Наташей. See, the ending ой becomes A. Let's take some more names. Таня с Таней. Маша с Машей. And guys, Коля с Колей. Петя с Петей. Ваня с Ваней. And also some male names that do not end with A, but still end with one of the soft sounds. In our case, with Y. Николай с Николаем. Сергей с Сергеем. At this stage, you better stop your player and drill the with someone form according to the pattern described in your transcript. Very good. Now, Lisa finally looks at Wednesday. In Russian, среда. Среда. The word среда ends with а, and so it changes when we want to say on Wednesday. So it is в среду. В среду. On Wednesday in the evening, she will be free. So she plans to go to a museum. In Russian, a museum – музей. Музей. To a museum – в музей. В музей. Free – for a lady – свободно. Свободно. I shall be – буду. So Lisa says, в среду вечером я буду свободна. Я пойду в музей. Or, if she would go with her friend Коля, she would say, в среду вечером мы с Колей пойдем в музей. And when a guy says, I shall be free, я буду свободен. Fine. And then comes Thursday, the fourth day. Четверг. Четверг. And on Thursday, в четверг. В четверг. On Thursday in the afternoon, Lisa will be at work. She will be busy. In the afternoon, but still in the daytime, in Russian, днем. Днем. She will be будет. At work, на работе. Busy, for a lady, занята. And for a guy, busy, занят. So we can say, в четверг днем Лиса будет на работе. Она будет занята. В четверг днем Лиса будет на работе. Она будет занята. I shall be, буду. So Lisa says for herself, в четверг днем я буду на работе. Я буду занята. But on Thursday in the evening, Lisa will visit her friends, Ivan and Vika. In Russian way, we may say, on Thursday in the evening, Lisa will go for a visit to Ivan and Vika. For a visit sounds in Russian something like maybe to be a guest or to make guests. In Russian it is в гости, like a guest, гость. And when there are some of them, it becomes гости. It's just a phrase. To visit someone, to go to someone в гости. В гости. You may just say в четверг вечером Лиса пойдет в гости. В четверг вечером Лиса пойдет в гости. To Иван, к Ивану. К Ивану. To Вика, Вика ends with А, к Вике. К Вике. So, в четверг вечером Лиса пойдет в гости к Ивану и Вике. See, it is enough to say only one «к», but it relates to both Ivan and Vika. So they both change. «К Ивану и Вике». Lisa says, «В четверг я пойду в гости к Ивану и Вике». Very good. And here comes Friday, the fifth day. Пятница. Пятница. And in the same way, like with Wednesday, среда, but on Wednesday, в среду, so it is also with Friday, пятница. On Friday, в пятницу. В пятницу. Lisa says, on Friday I'll be at home. В пятницу я буду дома. В пятницу я буду дома. And here comes Saturday. Суббота. Суббота. On Saturday. В субботу. В субботу. And on Saturday, Lisa makes a little party. And she has invited some of her friends. This party will take place in the afternoon, but still at the daytime. Днем. So Lisa says, on Saturday in the afternoon, Tanya and Коля will come to me. Or in Russian way, on Saturday in the daytime, to me will come Tanya and Коля. They will come, придут. To me, ко мне. Lisa says, в субботу днем ко мне придут Таня и Коля. В субботу днем ко мне придут Таня и Коля. And she could also say, on Saturday afternoon, Tanya and Коля will come to me for a visit, or to make guests. В субботу днем ко мне в гости придут Таня и Коля. В субботу днем ко мне в гости придут Таня и Коля. And finally Sunday. Воскресенье. Воскресенье. Like on Sunday there was Chris and yeah. Was Chris and yeah. Воскресенье. And on Sunday, в воскресенье. On Sunday, Lisa will ride with Коля and Таня to their дача. To дача, на дачу. She will ride, поедет. В воскресенье Лиса поедет с Колей и Таней на дачу. Or Lisa could say for herself, в воскресенье мы поедем с Колей и Таней на дачу. В воскресенье мы поедем с Колей и Таней на дачу. Or she could say, I shall ride to dacha to Коля and Таня. Let's say Коля and Таня are already there. Я поеду на дачу к Коле и Тане. Very well done. Now let's summarize. Lisa is passing through the days of the week and she says to herself. Так, сегодня понедельник. Сегодня вечером я пойду к Крису. Во вторник утром я иду на работу. Во вторник вечером мы идем с Иваном и с Викой в ресторан. В среду вечером я буду свободна. В среду вечером мы с Колей пойдем в музей. В четверг днем я буду на работе. Я буду занята. В четверг вечером я пойду в гости к Ивану и Вике. В пятницу я буду дома. В субботу днем ко мне в гости придут Таня и Коля. В воскресенье мы поедем с Колей и Таней на дачу.
Very good. Now let's do another drill, as described in the transcript, drill number 2.
Very well done. So that's enough for today, and see you in the next lesson. Пока!